the stars, the moon, the sun, everything God has placed in a place. If one star moves away, it will go and hit somewhere else. It will danger oneself and danger the another. God has placed you. Take care of your standard. Don't stoop yourself. Don't throw yourself. And you will end up in danger. Yes. Adam and Eve, God created them. But they did not understand God. That's why in the book of Zechariah, chapter 2, verse 7 and 8, God says, "Oh, my daughter of Israel, my daughter of Judah, you are in Babylon, but take care of your position. The people in Babylonians, they live in a particular way, but you are a chosen generation. I have separated you. You are mine." Read the word of God.
"As the angel who spoke to me came forward, another angel met him and said, 'Run and tell this to the young man. Jerusalem will remain unveiled because of its multitude of people and livestock. For this is the word of Yahweh. I myself will be around her like a wall of fire, and also within her in glory.'"
Zechariah chapter 2 verse 7. "O daughter of Zion, you are in Babylon. Take care where you are supposed to be. Take care of your position. Don't move away from your position." We read in the book of Revelation, chapter 2 verse 4. The Lord said, "What is the love for which I have created you? What happened to your first love that you had for the Lord? Once upon a time, when the Lord redeemed you, when the Lord drawn you, you had so much love for him. For Jesus, I will ready to do anything. You are running for him. Today, what has happened to that love? Where have you lost that love? Once upon a time, you are hungering for God. You want to do much things for God. You are filled with hungering for God. What has happened to you? Where are you? Where are you? O daughter of Zion, who is in Babylon, does the culture of Babylon, does the desire of Babylon, the life of Babylon, has entered into you and defile you and threw you away from the glory for which I have kept for you, I have chosen you. If the moon doesn't remain in its place, if it falls in another, it will destroy itself and the another. God has given you a standard. Remain in that standard. In his holy hands, let him fulfill the purpose for which he created you. And check yourself. Where are you? For what place you need to stand for which God created you? And now where are you standing? What have you done with your life which I have given to you with glory and power? What happened to the love that you had for me some time ago? How did that love vapor, that disappear? God is calling us once again. We read in the Bible, the book of Judges, chapter 16, verse 21. Here we read about a man. A man who was made as a judge, judging the people of Israel, to guide and direct the people of Israel. But what has happened to him? And they plucked his eyes, and they tied his hands and feet with chains, and they took him to the place of Gaza. Gaza is a place of evil, black magic, soothsaying place, a servant of God who was created to be in God's glory, to judge the people, to judge and guide the people. Today he is being judged by the enemy. He is caught by the enemy. He is supposed to be light to the people. Today his eyes are plucked away. He is called to protect his people. Today his hands and feet were chained with. He is supposed to lead the people to God. Today he is led to the place of evil. Yes, continue.
And he ground at the mill in the prison.
And they threw him into the dark prison to make fun for those Philistines. If we do not understand the position, the purpose for which God has created us, we will be thrown away. There is a place called the mercy of God, where God shows mercy and compassion for his children. And then we move away from the grace, that mercy of God, and still we play around with ourselves. Move away from the place where God is kept. The second stage, God comes and meets us with something called grace. Grace means he supplies for which we don't even deserve. And then we don't understand the grace. Still we continue to play around with our life and throw away ourselves. God asks, where are you? We don't bother. Then his grace moves away. And then we land up in the hands of the enemy. And the enemy destroys our lives. Like Adam and Eve, who lost the glory of God. Like Samson, who was tied up. We too landed up somewhere in the wrong place and in the wrong hands. Yes, we are all weak beings. But if we call upon him, if we remain with what we are, who we are, we will live by him. A soldier who went away, who struggled in the Second World War, a companion of Bush, he narrates that as he was traveling, suddenly the enemy's bombs were thrown away, and that bomb separated him with his other companions. He did not know what to do. Suddenly, he saw an old building. He was crawling in darkness and entered into. He heard the voice. He was crying, Lord, please protect me. A voice said, where are you? His name is Alfred. Alfred, where are you? I kept you gloriously. I protected you. But how have you lived your life? Now where are you landed up? Within few minutes, the enemies will see you and they will finish you up. In that place he wept, Lord, I'm sorry. I'm sorry. You kept me as the captain to lead the people. But I became a drunkard. I became a lazy beggar. I did not do my duty. I was leading others to drink and drink. And when the war came, my sin is coming behind me. Within few minutes, the enemies will surely will look at this building and they will enter into the building and they will finish me up. I'm sorry. I'm sorry for my sins. I'm supposed to be with you. I went away from you and I am landed up here. The voice said, I showed many times mercy to you. Now I show my grace to you. Take care of your life. as the voice heard, he saw a spider coming and putting itself in front of his room. He said, Lord, I asked you to protect me, but you are sending the spider. And the spider from top to down the room covered it. Within no time he heard the enemy's soldiers coming with their boots. They went to every room. And when they came to this room, they saw the spider. They were not willing to go inside. Nobody will be here, they said. And they moved away into some another place to look for the enemy. God said, I will rebuild you. And he became the great missionary Alfred, going to Africa, New Guinea, where he shared God's word and brought thousands of souls to Christ. When a man comes to realize where I am supposed to be and where have I am landed up my life with, and when he repents and returns back to God, the mercy of God comes upon man and he rebuilds his life.